Hey friends, it's Shane from HowToWrench.com, and we have got another tool to review. So we can't thank companies enough for giving ToolsWrench.com a chance to try and check out your tool. Definitely guarantee that we're going to give an honest review. And so if you see something on here at our new website, ToolsWrench.com, you're going to see that those are products that we actually use or would recommend. So let's get to it. Hey, what are you doing? Have you hit that subscribe button, that notification bell? You're going to be missing out on videos and free prizes and raffles we have coming up. We're excited to open this guy up today here. We've got a battery starter charging system test. Really like the packaging. First off, I know a lot of people doing tool reviews make big deals. We're not going to cut the box and all that kind of stuff here. We're going to get to the test here. But definitely a nice case. And when you open it up, you're going to see nice foam package compartments. I think that's important. I think it shows part of the quality of a tool to say, hey, we care enough about this to give you a way to store it. So you're going to get some cables. You can actually hook this up to your computer and download it. You got a couple of rolls of printer paper, a couple extra rolls of that. And then the tool itself, you can see it's going to be really, really simple. So we've got just simple battery connections, and I am going to model and demonstrate this on multiple batteries here in a second. I got automotive batteries, I have marine batteries, and then I have motorcycle batteries. So we're going to get this tested on all those and show you all the capabilities of it. But the first thing that I kind of notice here is that I've seen a lot of these testers where the cables are really, really, really super thin, and that's a big turnoff right away. So the first thing I notice is some decent gauge cables here. I know that the tool itself is going to do the magic. You know, we're used to dealing anything with batteries and doing old carbon pile testers. Here's a photo of one, what something like that would look like if you're not familiar. They're really, really heavy gauge. They get crazy hot. They're dangerous, and the fact that if you don't really know how to use a carbon pile tester, you could explode a battery, catch it on fire. So anyway, there's a lot of benefits to a tool that we could trust, and it's going to be able to do what we need to do to diagnose a battery under load. That is the whole key. Where people really get into trouble is they think they can take a multimeter and go across the battery and do surface voltage testing, and that's it. They're going to know the health of that battery. The traditional cheap load testers basically just gave you a go, no go. If you had a battery that went right through the gauge, you'd know right away, hey, it's not worth investing in this, time to just get a new one. Where a tool like this not only tests the battery, but it's gonna tell you what it tested at. So like you'll see the examples here where we have a measured rated battery that we're going to say it's 500 amps. The one they actually tested at the factory must have been a 500 amp battery. And then it shows that it measured at 580. So that would tell you, well, you got a good battery then. You move forward. But if I have something that's at 500 amps and I'm only getting 400 amps out of it, that tells you that that battery is going towards its end of life. Because you could take a weak battery and still show the vehicle still start and it'll seem like the charging system's working, but when you have that weak battery, you're taxing everything. You're taxing the starts, you're taxing the starter cable, the starter, the charging system, and everything. So we want a battery that's going to supply voltage and accept voltage easily, not have a bunch of restriction as the cases with batteries as they start to fail. That charging system has to work harder to fill that battery, which in essence works the charging system harder or even the starting system, and I think you get where I'm going with that. We're going to be able to check all those things with this tool. Also, I'm going to give some highlights on how not to use this tool wrong, because if you do the battery test and it fails, you need to replace the battery. That's not going to help you in checking the starting and charging systems with a weak battery. So let's just go ahead and do some examples now, and then we'll wrap this up on a product review of how we feel about it. This is going to be my first time using it, so I'm excited to put this thing through its paces and give it a good workout. We are just going to test the battery right now. To do so, we're going to go here and find on the battery. We need some numbers off it. On this particular one, it's 730 cold cranking amps. When we set the tool here, we're doing cold cranking amps. So on this one, it's 730. Let's go ahead and set it up here. All right, we simply hook up the tester, it'll automatically power up. So we're gonna hit menu. To shorten up this video, we went ahead and divided it into parts. So run over to part 5 for tips for use, and we'll show you how to set the language and timestamp. So if you're unsure what type of battery you have, Google it. There's a bunch of other choices in here. This thing gets pretty dang detailed into flat plate, spiral, gel, EFB. All right, so we're gonna go ahead on ours. It's just a regular flooded, cold cranking amp, select input. Love how infinitely adjustable this is. There we go, hit okay. And we're testing, just simply that fast. Now, by the way, this is a new battery. Good battery, so internal resistance, pretty cool. We don't really have a spec for that, but we do have our voltage right now. I've been driving it, so it should be up there around that 12.6, 12.8. 12.6 is a fully charged battery. If you don't know much about batteries, get over to our playlist on electrical, and we've got a lot of good content on that. So it's rated at 730. This actually passed at 795 cold cranking amps. So good to know that my new battery is good. Well, with that being said, I can go on now and do the other tests of this vehicle. So if I go back to menu here, just gonna hit OK. Now we'll do a cranking test. Okay, start engine. Cranking normal. Dropped, tells you the volt drop that it dropped to. Fantastic. We love this information. Hit okay. Okay, now we'll go to a charging systems test. You can see right now, and you got to be careful with the charging system test, because some vehicles, if the battery's fully charged, the alternator will actually shut off the alternator and it'll look like it's not charging. So you're almost better off to like turn the key on, leave the headlights on for like 30 seconds to drain the battery just a little bit, and then do the charging system test, because it'll see, oh wait, I need to fully charge this battery. So it's telling me to increase the RPM. See how we did this time. Boom. Everything looking good. We knew this vehicle was good, so this is a great example of this. Not understanding systems or not knowing about the vehicle that you're working on can give you false information. And you can imagine how many times people are going into, you know, not to pick on anybody, but going into your, you know, auto parts store, where maybe, how do you know that that person really knows how to test the system? Like in this case, if they didn't know about that alternator, it has the ability to shut off and dump when it's not needed, it shows that there's something wrong. Somebody could be buying an alternator when they just don't need to. And this is why it's really important for you as a technician to learn that skill set solid, or if you're the do-it-yourselfer, you can get the answer yourself and not have to rely on some misguided information. I'll tell you this, really fast. I mean, think about this. In one tool, I was able to load test the battery, not just bench test it. I was able to check the starting system. That'll check the cables, the starter. If everything's good, then it's good. If it's bad, then we got to determine, well, is it a connection? Is it the starter? Is it a relay? I mean, what, you know, you'd have to go from there. But when good's good and bad's bad. So The other thing about the charging system, I like the fact that it would record loaded and unloaded. You'll see as we do a motorcycle. Hey friends, I'll just pause right there. If you're interested in the motorcycle version of this video, head over to part 3 and you'll get the detailed information on how to use this battery tester on motorcycles. Once again, this is why information, the correct information, is so crucial to getting you the right test results. We got to remember, whether you're working on this for a customer or you're working on it for yourself, we are absolutely just trying to do it right the first time. And I love tools like this that are allowing us to get good information and then make a determination on what to do next. I've got to say that top down here on your Artibattery 201 model tester, fantastic. We're going to have all the links to this stuff. You can check it out yourself. This thing is pretty cool. We are going to be using this at howtowrench.com and toolswrench.com like crazy. This is now our go-to tester. And we want to thank them for sponsoring us with this product. And I know a lot of times people think, oh, well, somebody gave you something, so of course you're going to talk great about it. We are going to talk great about great tools. And the fact is, if we've made the decision to go ahead and implement this as our tester, then that's the decision we make. And just because we were sponsored here at the channel, that doesn't reflect that. I wouldn't sponsor a tool that I'm not going to use and not believe in. I cannot stress that enough. Everybody wants to see a product review that's honest and authentic, and that's what we got here. So I guess what it really comes down to is the question is, would I buy one of these with my own money? And the answer right now is absolutely. I think when I look at the value of everything this can do, and for a professional customer standpoint, that you can give a printout to your customer, imagine tearing that off, staple it to the work order, and giving your customer that confidence that, hey, you know, we're legit. We have, you know, great tools, and we know what we're doing. So we can't thank you enough for stopping over to howtowrench.com and toolswrench.com and checking out our latest product review of what we've added to our own toolbox. If you like this, give it a like, hit the subscribe, notification bell so you never miss out on anything. We've got some upcoming raffles where we're going to be giving prizes and stuff away to our members of our website. So we love having you here. Can't thank you enough for spreading this message of lessons in craftsmanship. Make it a great day and keep wrenching.